Here's the good news. They're going to start to listen to bullied targets more than ever. That's why we're making this new tape, our first update in years and years and years. Because I sense a change in the wind. It's called the Zeitgeist, sign of the times. In the air right now, thanks to the Me Too and the Time's Up revolution, the fact that women, long abused historically, who were ignored historically, have risen up in numbers, told their stories, made themselves so incredibly vulnerable. Usually abuse at the hands of these guys, and has started naming and shaming them and breaking the silence, is something that's going to benefit the workplace bullying movement too. Because I'm going to show you why and how. But we are riding on the coattails of the Me Too, and we are grateful for that. Now, you may not have worked for someone as bad as a Harvey Weinstein, but you've worked for little Harvey Weinsteins. And the thing is about bullying is it ignores the gender barrier. It ignores the EEO categories. It goes beyond sexual harassment. Your harasser can be a woman, as in Devil Wears Prada and the rest. So what are some of the lessons for the bully targets? Well, both sexual harassment and bullying thrive on secrecy and silence of the targets, the individuals, the victims. They want you to stay quiet. Well, you know what keeps a person quiet is a sense of personal shame. Guilt is a feeling that you might have if you were caught doing something wrong or you did something, you failed to, let's say, stand up to the bully. And you kicked yourself over that because you say, you think an hour later, oh my gosh, I should have said this and this and that. Oh, I knew what I did, but you didn't. And so you beat yourself up over that. That's guilt. Guilt over behavior not executed in that case. But shame. Shame is a result of the humiliation strategy that somebody else foisted upon you. Shame is the feeling of worthlessness, that I am a bad person, not that I did a bad thing or I did something wrong. Shame is something shared by all abuse victims, whether it's child abuse or domestic violence or work abuse. Shame is externally caused. Someone, the dominant person, thinks that they can, through humiliation tactics, convince a otherwise thoroughly competent, wonderful person to feel worthless. So all abuse shares an underlying form of worthlessness. That's the theme. And you cannot give in to that. You cannot agree to that. You cannot believe that big lie. Well, that's what you share, we all share with the Me Too movement, the bully targets. For the first time, the second bullet is so important. The target's perspectives are taken more seriously than the perpetrator's rationalizations. That's the sea change. That's what's for decades, the men were believed, the women were not believed. They were denied the reality, and now it's all turned on the heads, and these men are revealed as liars, and the institutions have been revealed as their rationalizers and their support system. Abuse is underreported and delayed. That's true. All forms. In severe instances, even a single event can traumatize a person. Well, that's the definition in the clinical Bible, the DSM, that for PTSD to be diagnosed. It's a single life-threatening event. But in reality, most of your experiences as a bully target and those of sexual harassment victims is a slow burn, a steady, repeated pattern. Chronic abuse over time, cumulative abuse, cumulative trauma, cumulative incidents, numerous incidents. Okay. I already told you that sexual harassment and mental health effects are less severe than those suffered by people who are bullied at work. Reporting timeframes are handcuffs. That's interesting. There's a six-month timeframe that you must file a sexual harassment lawsuit. The thing is, trauma is often delayed, its onset is delayed, and it lasts a really, really long time. So you might be months and months into, let me even complicate it more. In bullying, it may take you months to even recognize that you're being bullied. I'm going to demonstrate how that happens in a second here. But as unbelievable as that sounds, yes, it takes a long time. It may take a year before you actually or can be convinced that what's happening to you is wrong. Then the impact, once you recognize that, the mental health onset takes time. this all adds up. So if you're limited to a six-month time frame, you might miss that. So as companies start to bring on more and more anti-bullying policies, be aware that the time frames, the deadlines to respond may be unfair. They really need to be played out into a year or two or three years. I'm sorry, HR, you are feckless. Period. You're useless. You are a management support function, but you don't tell people that. There's no shame in being a management support function if you just wouldn't keep trying to pretend to be employee advocates. Only unions are employee advocates, and friends of non-unionized workers are employee advocates. But HR is not an employee advocate, and they screw this up terribly, both for sexual harassment and more so for bullying. Targets aren't believed. It's very hard to corroborate the story, especially when the harassment and or the bullying happens behind closed doors. So that's a problem. Coworkers get scared easily, and they'll go side with the perpetrator. And that's sad because now the target is abandoned. Helpful witnesses must be mobilized to act. Well, it's taken several decades, but finally, thanks to the MeToo movement's momentum, there's a snowballing effect. Once some people start to come forward, there's a snowballing effect. When bullying is left with only a single accuser, over time, it becomes construed as he said, she said, or she said, she said. One, you know, he said, she said. And therefore, HR likes to throw up their hands and say, what can we do? What can we do? But as you can see with Cosby, 55 accusations made it he said, and all the rest said she said. If only we had this kind of a situation in the workplace where people knew, because they are repeat offenders, not only with single targets, but across different targets over the years. They could account for the turnover of many, many people over the years, and yet it went undetected until finally the bullied targets all started to get together and talk about the record, and they'd see it was many, many she saids. Employers respond in predictable, terrible ways. Denial, basically. Training is not a solution. Training alone is not adequate. There can be some training, basically, to teach people to recognize what's going on. But then the next bullet is important. But if the policies that are put in place are weak, they're as bad as having no policies. So it's essentially very impossible to get genuine accountability, which is what people want. Permanent solutions may yet happen. I have hope. That's what's coming out of the Me Too movement. I think that they're compelling employers to be responsible. And basically, it's the legal professions telling the professionals who work for the employers are saying, hey, you better get this fixed up. And some of the wiser ones even say, address bullying. Even though it is still perfectly legal in the U.S., you really should address it, thanks to them. When we throw the word accountability around, I'm going to bring this list up again later, but I wanted to put it out there right now to put it in your mind, because this is really one of your goals, isn't it? Bully targets want justice in a variety of ways. They want the justice. They want the reversal of their economic misfortune. They want the money restored. They want their paid time off, their leave time that they've had to burn for mental health days put back in the bank. They want to hold on to the job that they love. They want the bully fired. They want, but that doesn't happen enough. But they definitely want separation from that bully, and that should happen all the time. But we always throw the word around, we want accountability. I want them to understand. I want them, that individual, to pay for it, what they've done to me at the behest of the organization. Well, these are the five characteristics of accountability, and look at how hard they are to accomplish. Number one, the perp has to acknowledge that they are responsible for their own actions. They got to fess up to it, and they will rarely do that. The employers have to compel them to do that. In fact, I'm invited now into organizations to work with high-profile, highly educated, extremely highly paid bullies, where the employers are saying, own up to it. Make them own up to it. So unless the employer makes them own up to it, they will blame their conduct on everything, the weather, just a million other things, no doubt. So, second, there has to be acknowledgement of the impact of their actions on other people. And again, I go in and I make them aware. I give them the evidence. I show them the evidence, and it's corroborated and they can't deny it, but they have to see it. Now, there's a vulnerability here. Because of the health impact nature of bullying, there's a vulnerability of the target to basically show or demonstrate to the employer how severely impacted you were, which then opens up your medical records to the employer, which can be dangerous. So it's always good to show impact on at least the work product, on the workflow, on productivity, if you will. Third, the perpetrator should express genuine remorse. Wow, that's rare. That's really, really, really rare. But we should work toward that. They're not going to change, but within the workplace, they can at least constrain their behavior and change their behavior at work. We're not going to re-engineer their personalities, just know that. But very few will express remorse. Fourth, they should take actions to heal the harm they caused. Well, you see how rare that's going to be. And then finally, and this is actually more probable, that they will not commit the harm again. So they're not going to be allowed to continue the harm toward anyone else after you. Well, that can be done in the workplace. So I'd say points 1, 2, and 5 are possible. 3 and 4, I have yet to see that actually ever happen. But when you say, I want them held accountable, I want you to see this and be able to put forth these steps, these principles to the employer.